Good morning. Welcome to Holy Cross Church as we honor the life of Joanne. Just a couple housekeeping items before we begin. The restrooms are in the back through the center doors and to the right if you should need them during Mass. Masks are not required in church. It is not mandated. It is up to you for your comfort level. So please know that if you want to wear it, you're welcome to, and if you don't, that is fine also. When it is time for communion, Father will explain how we do communion here at Holy Cross. At this time, we ask you to please turn off your cell phones. Please stand and turn towards the back.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Holy Cross Parish. My name is Father Joseph Marticello, and on behalf of Father Coffus, our pastor, myself, and the whole parish staff, we extend our deepest sympathies and sincere condolences to you and your family and friends as you come here today to weep and mourn the loss of our dear sister and friend, Joanne, and as we lift her up in prayer and commend her to the mercy of Almighty God. In the waters of baptism, Joanne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Please join in singing the opening hymn, number 578 in the Red Book, How Great Thou Art, number 578.
I see the stars.
this time, I would invite you to please be seated as I invite William, longtime family friend, forward to share a few words about Joanne.
Strong microphone, so.
I'm very strong.
It doesn't need to be too close.
I didn't know I was going to do the lead off. I'm honored to be able to speak today about our dear friend, family member, Joanne. There are two types of people in this world. There's givers, takers. Joanne was certainly top of the list as a giver. And in the next few minutes, I'm going to discuss and present several examples that either Joanne shared or I've experienced with her. Earlier in Joanne's life, when her mother died, her brother Billy needed some help. She and her late husband Jerry brought him in, raised him, nurtured him, and he turned out very well. This is just the first example of her giving. When Jerry passed, his colleagues said, "Oh, you're fit for life, Joanne, no problem." They all thought that. Joanne found out that wasn't true, and she went on a crusade to tell all of her co-workers, "You better get your union together and get some benefits for the widows." Although it wouldn't benefit her, it certainly benefited other people. Yet, another opportunity for her to give. Now, there's a few humorous events in her life that I'd like to share. This one I'm going to call the cat in the duct. Joanne was kitty-sitting for one of, I think it was one of your kitties, Kim. She called up Sharon and said, "I can't find the cat." Sharon, my wife, says, "I'll be right over." So a few minutes later, Joanne called me. "Hey, Bill, we have a problem." I said, "What's our problem?" "I can't find the cat, and I think I know where he is." So I went over, and apparently the cat, when somebody painted previously the cover for the return air duct, never got put back on, and the cat went in there. So we went downstairs, and listen, I have a stethoscope. I listened. I could hear him breathing, and I did a little destruction on the duct work. I think Brian ended up having to fix it after I got done. Got the kitty out. Brought him upstairs. I says, "Is this the right cat?" She says, "Oh, thank you." So this would appear as if she was receiving, which she did. But as a thank you, she made the most fantastic dinner for Sharon and I. The thank you was 10 times more than what we did. Again, just another example. Now, Joanne never learned how to drive. But several years ago, she thought, maybe I should. So she did get a learner's permit, took a few lessons. And I guess one day, backing into the driveway, she smacked the pole light. Decided, I guess I shouldn't be driving. It's only a little bit bent, but that's a good remembrance of what happened. So she had many friends that would take her to doctor's appointments and shopping. And every Friday, she would have a get-together with all these folks and provide dinner for them. Again, the thank you was far more generous than the gifts given. Well, they called it the Friday night group. So that was quite enjoyable for her. And I snuck in every once in a while because you can tell I love to eat. Again, that's just one more example of the giving person she is. Joanne loved Christmas. Oh, goodness. She started decorating her house, I think, before Halloween. Not a square inch without a decoration. Of course, she had the nativity scene. And then Christmas Day was her dinner. And we started eating. I'm not going to go through the whole thing because we'll be here for a long time. We started eating around 3 o'clock and finished in the wee hours of the morning. And I had quite a surprise when I ate a meatball. Something seemed wrong. What's in the meatball? I think Kim said raisins. It was a shock, but I finally turned out to like them. She taught my daughter how to make them that way, too. She said, this is what you get from Napoli. It's okay. Joanne did a lot of work. She donated her time to the PTA. They call it the Scott Shop. It's a used clothing and household appliances. It was right at the school across the street from her house. And she and Sharon and many other folks put in countless hours helping. The proceeds all went to the PTA, West Irondequoit School District. And on sale days, Joanne decided, we got to eat. So she prepared food for 20 or 30 people. I know this because I helped haul it over. Of course, I got first dibs. Quite a feast. Again, giving. That is Joanne. She loved cookies. She loved to make other sweets, giving countless trays of her fresh goodies on any event, weddings. For our daughter, Carrie Lee's wedding, I think there were 18 trays of various cookies, cannolis, pizzelles, you name it. Joanne made it all. Just, again, another example of her giving. About 25 years ago when my father died, we had the reception after the funeral at our house. We have a large garage. And Joanne couldn't come right away because she was babysitting other kids. But she showed up a little later, grabbed a broom, started to clean up. I said, Joanne, relax a little bit. And she gave me her, William. That's all she had to say, which meant, Stutterzeek, be quiet, I'm cleaning, case closed. And she did. She did a fantastic job. And again, just giving, giving, giving. And I'm sure as I've been speaking, I've been looking out and I'm seeing many people going, yeah, yeah. And I'm sure you have many more examples yourself of Joanne's giving, because she's touched all of our lives. And I'm sure right now she is up preparing the largest container of eggplant parmesan and sharing it with the other angels. Again, I thank you for the opportunity to speak. We wish Joanne a safe journey. Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Joanne to be inscribed in the book of life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. At this time, I'd like to invite James and Danielle forward as they are going to proclaim our readings this morning.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. But now this says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the water, I will be with you. In the rivers, you shall not drown. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned. The flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord, your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Because you are precious in my eyes and glorious, and because I love you, do not be afraid, I am with you. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this, on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, a long life provides us the opportunity to enjoy and to appreciate so many of God's gifts and blessings. And that's exactly what Joanne experienced. A long life filled with God's goodness and grace. God blessed her with a beautiful life, with a beautiful family, with many good people and friends, with many gifts and talents, and with all the wonderful things that was said of her in the words of remembrance. And what a blessing it is that so shortly after her death, despite the grief and heartache you feel today, you can still smile whenever you think of her. Even death can't rob you of the joy that Joanne brought into your life. And so we thank Almighty God today for all of those beautiful memories. It is true that Joanne's life was filled with so many blessings from God, but perhaps the greatest blessing of them all was the blessing Joanne received at her baptism, the blessing of being made a child of God, the blessing of faith, the blessing of mercy and grace, which flowed from the pure sight of Jesus on the cross into Joanne's soul upon her reception of the sacraments, where she was nourished and fortified by God's love. The Lord was with Joanne her whole life. Thus, it is our great hope that the Good Shepherd was also present at her final breath to lead Joanne home from this life into the eternal pastures of paradise. And he was certainly there, because I was so privileged to be there and to administer to her the sacraments, the last sacrament, the sacrament of the sick. And so above all, Joanne was a beloved child of God. And though imperfect, like the rest of us, she still belonged to God. And as a baptized Christian, no sin committed can ever erase or diminish that identity of being a child of God. That indelible mark is there forever. And so from the beginning of her life in Christ, upon being washed in the waters of regeneration, until her final breath, Joanne belonged to the Lord. And of those who belong to the Lord, Christ says, "No one can take them out of my hand." This is our very hope as Christians. And St. Paul elaborates on our Christian hope when he says, "None of us lives for himself, and none of us dies for himself. If we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's." And we know that Joanne certainly did not live for herself. She rather lived generously for others, for her family, and ultimately for the Lord. And of course, we are also consoled by the words of our blessed Lord, who said in the gospel, which we heard today, "This is the will of him who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I shall raise it up on the last day." And so, my friends, it is our great hope that Joanne will rise from the dead on the last day, sharing in the glory and in the joy of Christ's blessed resurrection. Joanne was blessed by God indeed, but she did not keep these blessings only for herself. She shared them generously with others, with each of you. That's why Joanne was also a blessing to each of you. And talk about her as a giver, being so generous and giving many things. The greatest gift she shared with you is the greatest gift God gave the world, the gift of his only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who alone provides the perfect love, the perfect peace, the perfect joy, the perfect fulfillment we all look for in life. And she is still giving that gift today with this funeral mass, allowing all of us to be here with our blessed Lord in the most blessed sacrament. Joanne knew that Jesus is the only one who can bless us with a peaceful and holy death, the only one who gives true solace and comfort to the afflicted and sorrowing, the only one who gives meaning and hope to our lives, the only one who can save us and grant us eternal life, the only one who has conquered sin and death and can therefore make us conquerors over sin and death as well, the only one who is the way, the truth, and the life. And that's why Joanne followed the Lord so faithfully throughout her life. Jesus is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And Jesus was certainly the beginning and the end of Joanne's blessed life upon this earth. And so we have great hope that Joanne passed through our Lord and Savior by living in him and by dying in him. Now may she share in the glory of the Lord forever. And as we say farewell today to Joanne, let us also consider how we want to live the rest of our lives. Let us consider whether we want to live for the empty promises of the world or for Jesus Christ and the promise of eternal life. The promise Joanne hoped for and lived for. Because, my friends, we will have no regrets if we choose to follow Christ faithfully. We certainly won't be disappointed. The pain, the struggle, and the sacrifices, the cross of the Christian life will be as nothing compared with what is to come. For St. Paul reminds us that no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor has it entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared for those who love him. Joanne, may the angels be your guide. May they lead you into paradise and take you home to the new Jerusalem. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. With faith, let us bring our prayers and petitions to the Lord who hears us.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Joanne, who was given the promise of eternal life in baptism, may the Lord give her communion with the saints forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all those who loved and were loved by Joanne, that you may find comfort in your belief in the Lord's promise of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For each of you, with whom Joanne so generously shared her many gifts, may you too grow in the ability to share your gifts and lighten the burdens of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all who have died in the hope of rising again, especially Joanne, her husband Jerry, her parents, William and Dorothy, as well as other family members who've gone before her. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For Joanne's family, especially her daughter and son-in-law, Kim and Brian, her grandsons, James and Brendan, Joanne's siblings, William, Sally, John, and Kathy, her nephews and nieces, William, Nicole, John W., and John P., several cousins in Erie, Pennsylvania, as well as her extended family and dear friends, that they feel the healing power of Christ in the midst of their sadness and grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For each of us present here today, that God will bless us richly with the gifts he knows we need to fully celebrate life and recognize the new beginning he offers us each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. And let us pause and make our own private petitions in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
We unite these and all our poor prayers to those of the Immaculate Blessed Virgin Mary, and speak them in the name of her Son, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. At this time, I'm going to invite up Stephanie, Megan, Jennifer, and Haley to the side, who will bring forward our gifts, please.
Please join in singing the offertory hymn number 680 in the Red Book, Be Not Afraid, number 680.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid,
If you pass through raging waters in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the roar of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Joanne, on whose funeral day we offer you the sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Joanne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Holy Communion, I will administer Holy Communion on this side first, and then I'll come over and minister Holy Communion to this side. Please come forward and receive Holy Communion by placing the host within your mouth. I also ask that if you are not Catholic, to please refrain from receiving Holy Communion out of respect for the Blessed Sacrament and out of respect for your own faith. Instead, you may come forward and receive a blessing from me with your arms crossed like this. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
His word, my hope.
for those who are watching the act of spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. You will notice in your program inside cover, there's an invitation to join Joanne's family at Mary Hart's home at 599 Pine Grove Avenue following entombment at Holy Sepulchre Cemetery.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Joanne, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Joanne. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Take
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Joanne, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our sister Joanne to her place of rest.
Please join in singing the closing hymn, number 690 in the Red Book on Eagle's Wings, number 690.